Those who sow in tears will reap songs of joy. Those who are weeping, they are receiving. will see him as he is, and all who have bestowed him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Let us abide in that purity with the assurance that in Jesus Christ we are forgiven. Amen.
Listen to what this boy says. I'm a person of hope, so when you come against a big mountain, you'll have to remember you have a big God. So this boy had any opportunity to ask for anything. Make a wish, you can go to the Magic Kingdom, you can get Nintendo, anything you want. And of all things this boy wants to do is to feed the homeless. Amazing. It's amazing to think that children are instilled these Christian values at such a young age. And God bless the parents for doing this. It says, what a beautiful example of how this one kid has been able to unite an entire community. To this day, businesses donate food. And this is 2 years later. And it's called Abraham's Table. And just amazing to think that this is something they don't teach in school. It's taught in Sunday school, and it's taught at home. To think that any kid of the world might have asked for something for their own special needs, and this boy, with God's influence, decided to give. And it's an incredible story, and I just thought I'd thank you, and just, you know, God bless you parents for doing what you do, bringing your children here. Being educated not by Caesar, but by him. So on that note, I'm sure to go off to Sunday school, but Emily's here. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again and summoned Jesus and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this reason I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So, aside from being Christ the King Sunday, it's also the first. It's the weekend before Thanksgiving. So, give you a little background to this. This is often an Easter reading. It's right before the crucifixion of Christ. However, it's talking about the kingdom, and it was one of the texts selected by the presbytery, which is appropriate for Christ the King Sunday. So, if you look at this, as Jesus is being handed over, it's a political unrest at the time. You've got the Jews, you've got the Romans, and they're at odds with each other. The Jews couldn't crucify Christ. However, the Romans had the authority to do so. Yet, here we have a worldly leader, and he's asking him, "What did you do wrong?" And the Jews are saying he's defying the government, and that's the basis for his guilt, and what they're going to condemn him to death for. As the text goes on, if you notice this, Jesus is always going to answer a question with a question. See that throughout the Bible. And he said to him, "Who do you say that I am?" Pilate knew that he had no guilt, there's no fault in this man. And yet he had to do what he had to do because of the political unrest at the time. If we were to go back to chapter 19, which follows this, you're going to see that the Jews were extremely angry because they said to him, Pilate put a sign on him, as was common with all people who were about to be crucified, what their guilt was. And the sign said in bold letters, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." And they ran up to him and said, "You can't put that on there. You should have said, he's saying that he's King of the Jews. Not that he is a King of the Jews, but yet he is." And his ministry for 3 years, he went throughout Judea, all of the provinces, talking about the kingdom of heaven. And this morning we're going to talk about the kingdom and how if you believe in death, the burial, the resurrection, that you become a citizen of this kingdom. It's the only way in. But a lot of people will say, "Well, I know a lot of good folks. Are they not going to go to the kingdom?" And the fact of the answer is, it's true. And this is a hard saying, but Jesus himself preached the kingdom of God, and he said, "I am the truth, and I'm the way. And you don't get into this kingdom unless you just believe." And it's woven all throughout. But as modern-day Christians, it's not too much difference between then and now, because people are looking for signs. Yet we don't look with our eyesight. We see with our faith. And that's one of the things that makes you a believer and turns you into a citizen of that kingdom, because you've trusted in Jesus Christ. And at that point, your soul is separated from your flesh. Your flesh is going to be something. We live in a sin-cursed world, and so we have this fleshly body. it's going to fight. It's always going to fight with that spiritual man inside or woman. We have kingdom perspective, but we have a worldly perspective. And as Christians, it's important to know it's like an alternate reality. You can't see this kingdom unless you're looking at it through spiritual eyes. In contrast to this world system, the kingdom of heaven is our home. Here, things are temporary, imperfect. The kingdom of heaven is eternal. It's a place where we will live in perfection with no sin. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. If you look in the book of Galatians, those who walk by faith and not by sight are actually living out the Christian life. A lot of it has to do with just that trust and also your mindset. Romans chapter 12 has a wonderful verse which a lot of people hold as a life verse. It's about renewing of your mind and presenting yourself as a living sacrifice. It's not about money. It's not about anything. It's about giving of yourself. Just like that example of that young boy, he didn't give of anything that he had. No money. He gave of himself. And he started an avalanche of giving just by his example. And God's going to do that with us. He's going to take us, mold us and shape us. That process, once we become a believer, is part of being molded and shaped into his likeness. Whether we like it or not, it's painful. In the book of Jeremiah, the Lord uses an example about the potter's house and how the potter is molding and shaping clay on this wheel. And just like us, we're on that potter's wheel. We're being molded, being pulled, being shaped. The important thing is to not jump off the potter's wheel. Stick with it, and you will be conformed into his likeness. We'll never be perfect while we're in this existence and in this realm, but there will be a day of perfection because we're covered by his blood. And although the world might hear things like that, what a messy thing. Why did he have to do that? And they talk about the crucifixion, and they think, what a crazy religion. But remember, this is not religion. It's relationship. It's a vertical relationship. In this world, you will have tribulations, Jesus said, but be of good cheer, because I have overcome this world. That's part of his kingdom message. He's reminding people throughout his ministry, it's like opposite world. You're going to have trials, tribulation, and the important thing is that we don't live by these worldly standards. We live in a way that's very much like his kingdom. You don't see it, but we're living out through our faith. So, excuse me for the notes here, but I'm not sure if you've ever heard. So there's a hokey little song called "The World Is Not My Home." I'm not sure if anyone here has heard it, but it truly is. As a citizen of the kingdom, this world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. And that process of feeling foreign in this world is something that's common to the Christian walk. It's something that you will always feel at odds with him living inside you. It's going to take time, but your flesh is going to fight against us. It's going to say, don't quite listen to that, and don't watch that movie. You won't ever feel at ease, because this world is really not our home. It's up there. And it's interesting how quickly life does go by. Peter is quoted Isaiah And he said, a day with the Lord is but 1,000 years here. That's an amazing statement, because you think, well, God's never coming back. It's been 400 years from the book of Malachi to the first book of the New Testament, which starts out with Matthew. So if you did the math on this, if 24 hours is 1,000 years, half a day is 500 years, 6 hours is 250 years, 3 hours is going to be 125, an hour and a half is 61.25. 45 minutes is literally going to break down to 31 years. 15 minutes is going to break down roughly 11 years. It's amazing to think in kingdom time, 15 minutes is 10 years down here. This is Bible. When we have a loved one who's departed, they're going to be able to walk around the kingdom, introduced. A half hour goes by like this. And yet down here, we're in pain. We're in agony. We live in an imperfect world. Yet by the time they've seen the kingdom and they've seen their mansion, gee, they're coming home. They're going to be here any minute now. And that perspective is a kingdom perspective. And I think something so important to hold in mind while we're here struggling, suffering. You've got folks in heaven who are like 15 minutes is 10 years. I mean, it's an interesting perspective to hold, that your life will go by that quickly. By the time you turn 40, you think, wow, I got two more quarters to go. You get to 60, you're in the final quarter. You look back and go, where did my life go? What did I do with my life? Did I do anything for the kingdom? The Lord says, we store our treasures up there, not here. You can have a big bank account down here, but it means nothing. You came into this world with nothing, and you leave this world with nothing. But you leave behind a legacy. And for those of us who pray, I have a loved one who is not a believer, that prayer can be answered. That prayer can be answered when we're gone, because oftentimes, a life that is godly is going to leave an impression with people. And I don't know how many people have been to a funeral and afterwards they said, where can I get a Bible? Where can I learn more about this kingdom that they believed in? And they want a piece of that. And it's amazing how that life is a testimony to those who lived a godly example, and it carries on. God's word does not go out void. It will return, and it's always doing the work. So I want to teach just something very quickly with the approach of Thanksgiving. There's a lot of prayer in the Bible about Thanksgiving, and I feel that one or two, if this be a blessing to anybody here, especially during this holiday season, in the chapter of Philippians, we have a prayer here where it's saying, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known to all men, the Lord is at hand. He's at hand because he's only maybe a day away. It could be 1,000 years, we don't know. In heaven's time, he might be looking at his clock and saying, I'm going back down. I'm going to take my church back. We don't know when he's coming back. However, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. The peace of God which passes all understanding. Through him, we call him the Lordship because we're in his ship. And this life is full of storms. A lot of people want to avoid those storms. You can't. They're always going to happen. However, he uses those opportunities to turn something for his glory, just like that young boy who got cancer. He didn't know, he knew us before we were formed in the womb. Did he know that that boy would have cancer? Maybe not. However, he used that circumstance to turn it for his glory. And that's what the Lord wants to do with everyone in this room, in his church family, is to use your life to shine for him. We don't shine as light. However, we become reflectors of that life, light. And that's what our purpose is here. The first century Christians who crucified Jesus said, "He's not the king of the Jews." However, at the same time, there was a cancel culture against the first Christians. You won't find the word Christian in the Bible. It's nowhere. They mentioned in a demeaning way as little Christs. They said, well, those people who are following Jesus, the little Christs. And part of, they were known as the way, if you see that. But all this to say that he can accomplish anything through us when we yield through and operate through faith. Courage uses the same pathway as fear. Whether you're facing storms in this life or your basic day-to-day cares, you have the choice. You can either be afraid and unsettled, which is easy to do, or you can be courageous and full of faith while you keep your eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. In Philippians, he also states, being confident of this very thing, that he which began a good thing, a good work in you, will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. We're always being molded into his form. Now, I think that with that being said, with Thanksgiving coming, pray that you all have a wonderful celebration. It's a wonderful time of year. It's also a tradition. And I think for those I wanted to mention briefly, it can also be a sad time of year for some. It's a sad time in some cases because we've lost a loved one. It's a sad time, especially during COVID, where we can't travel. Although traveling is happening again, but it's also a tradition. Thanksgiving, something that is in the Bible, yes. There's thankfulness that's given, but there's no dedicated feast. It's a tradition made by men. We can create our own family traditions. When I grew up, my father and my mother divorced when I was 2 years old, and it left a profound impact in that the holidays were often a sad time. I didn't have both parents in the house, and we didn't have family gatherings where there was joy. And I think that the sadness that I felt was because of the brokenness of my home, but at the same time, my father would come visit, and we'd often go to a Chinese food restaurant, of all things, for Thanksgiving. And amazing how we can take a tradition, which is non-traditional, and turn it into something that's special. And to this day, Chinese food has a very warm place in my heart. Not because of anything else, but it reminded me of my father, who I never got to see. I rarely saw him. I saw him maybe a dozen times before the age of 10. Very sad, but at the same time, this is our father up here. This is the kingdom of the world to whom every knee shall bow. And he's the one who will give you the comfort to make it through any time. We can be of good cheer because he has just overcome everything. And I think that's an important Thanksgiving message, is that we don't have to look at others and compare, gee, they're having a wonderful time. We can have Thanksgiving every day. And it truly is Thanksgiving every day when you hop in your car and it works. When you go to your house, you don't have a leak on the roof. when you've got food in your refrigerator. There's so many things to be thankful for, and yet we take them for granted. And I think that's the key thing, is just thank you, Lord. Thank you even if I got a flat tire. You know why? Maybe he saw there was a car crash coming down the road. He gave that flat tire on purpose to keep you safe. He protects God's children. He knows each and every one of you by name, and the Lord is infinite. There's about 700 billion people on this planet right now. He knows every heartbeat. He knows every person. He knows what you're going to do. And all you have to do is choose him and choose to go along for the ride as he takes you through this world. And on that note, I will leave it at that. I pray that you all have a wonderful Thanksgiving, that someone get a blessing from this, and someone get some comfort, because we all need that in this world. So, amen. If you'd like to stand, let me go to our affirmation. Okay. We affirm that God created the world as part of a grand design, and that the world in each of us has a purpose we are to fulfill. We maintain that Jesus Christ is central to God's design, and was sent to plant the seeds of a kingdom that even now is growing, almost invisibly among us, and is a light by the hope of eternal to all believers. We trust that the small things we do and say each day contribute to the eternal kingdom growing in our world, and that God's Spirit multiplies each of our small contributions to bring measurable blessings to fulfill God's purpose. Graced by your Spirit, we will plant seeds that bring forth spiritual fruit. We shall celebrate our hearts with thanksgiving and joy. Amen. Thank you. you would please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
So we have Mr. White here to receive your prayers. Backwards, however, that's fine.
Please join me in prayer. Almighty God, from the beginning of time to the end of eternity, you have chosen to use your power and majesty to love us, to redeem us, to shape us as your people. As the shepherd who cares for the flock, you guide all things through Jesus, whom you have exalted over all creation as King. Hear the prayers we offer in his name for the creation we cherish and that you entrust to us. Generous God, at this harvest time, we thank you for all the good things you give us. We thank you for our food. We remember all those who do not have even one proper meal each day. We pray for the homeless and those who depend on the charity of others. We pray for the work of the local food banks providing food for those in need. Help us to share the harvest of the world more fairly so everyone can be fed and there will be no more starvation. At this harvest time, we thank you for the hard work of all those who grow, protect, and prepare our food, for the shopkeepers, the delivery drivers, the processors, and the farmers. At this harvest time, we thank you for the world we see around us, the flowers, the trees, and the animals. Bless all those who care for them, Lord. Help us to protect your creation by being careful how we use your resources, so that there will be clean water, clean air, and plenty of animals and insects to maintain the ecological balance on our countryside. Harvest time brings many families together. Be with those that we pray for this day, thinking particularly of Noreen, Jean, Peachy, Iris, Nancy, Linda, Patsy, Nazare. We also raise up the families of Olga and Zenzi as they cope with their loss this week. God, in community, holy and one, may your word be on our lips as we pray together as Jesus has taught us. Once again, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Thank you.
benediction here. Thank you, Thomas, for doing this. Spirit of God, resting upon us, may your power inflame us with your peace. May your peace touch us with your grace. May your grace fill us with your hope. May your hope lead us into your kingdom. And now go in peace with the blessings of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And all the people said, Amen. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. And thank you to all the children for bringing up their gifts. And go in peace. Thank you.